May come in, sir?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am. How are you doing?
Good.
Please take it.
Thank you.
She can hear me.
It is marriage.
Give it with both the hands.
Sorry?
Give it with both the hands.
Want me to repeat again?
Yes.
Okay, I'll do it for you. I think it's fine.
So, Mr. Raja Indikuri, tell me about yourself.
I basically hail from a business family, but I got a passion to do Masters in Management. That's how I got into this MBA program. But later on I thought, I told my dad that I will not get into business. I'm looking for a job. That's how I got into MBA and I'm looking for a job.
So Raju, you said that your family is from basically a business background, right?
Yeah.
So why are you choosing again a job then?
I think I already mentioned that. I was from a business family. I thought when I was young, I will excel in business. But later I changed my mind that my personality fits into a company outset where I will be working for others' organizational goals rather than that. I'm not good in fixing the goals. My dad fixed that. I can't fix my own goals. So that's how I'm looking at a job. My interest is in finance, and thankfully my college gave me your company for the campus drive. I'm so fortunate to meet you all.
Have you gone through your job description?
Yes.
What?
It is an analyst position, equity analyst position.
Then send me the role.
Where your clients are investment bankers across Europe and the US.
What's your role?
My job would be probably to analyze process, disseminate the financial information, process it, and give back to the clients. That's how you make money. That's my understanding of your business model.
Okay, Mr. Raju, what is your best strength?
I'm good in many things, I should say that. People say my communication is good, I'm a team player.
Tell me the one thing.
One thing, it's very difficult to say, honestly, because it's not my own self-glorification. People tell me about it. That's how I'm trying to say that. So it's very difficult to pick one. If you ask me to give a set of strengths, I can definitely.
But you must be specific, right?
Yeah.
So tell me one strength.
One strength, I can say my attitude is kind of go-getter attitude. I do it.
Can you give an example, like life?
In my life, in my business life?
Yes.
Okay. Not as a student.
Yeah.
Okay. There was a problem while doing business. My dad was struggling for the sales and so on. He shared his problem over the night. And the next day, I came with a solution. And he was so happy that he assigned that job to me. But I told that it's not me who can take it forward, it is you. I'm there to give you the suggestion, but not the execution. I can say that.
You have completed your project in Kabi, right?
Sure.
Then let me know, what is short selling?
Short selling is all about, short selling is more relevant to trading, intraday trading, importantly in equity stock markets, where you don't have stock with you, but you want to sell it. The reason here is I'm anticipating the market to crash, and I want to make the advantage out of it. So when I sell now and buy it later, I make money out of it. So it's all about leveraging on the volatility of price.
Then what's your position? You want to be an investor or a trader?
I want to be an analyst. That's how I'm here with you. Neither I want to be an investor nor a trader. I want to be an analyst.
Could you tell me something which is not there in resume?
Many things actually. You know, I'm a daydreamer. I dream my day every hour, I should say that. Importantly, in the leisure time, when I travel, when I go to bed, when I come out of the bed, I do that, and I try to integrate that to this business so that my dad get some leverages. So same is the case when I get with your company also. So I feel I should be productive.
So tell me how you will engage your day-to-day activities.
My day is so systematic, believe me. It starts early in the morning, 5 o'clock. On dot, 5 o'clock, I'm off. I jump out of the bed, 5 to 7, I fresh up and do yoga. I attend sunrise every day near to my beach. I go there, come back, and have some Surya Namaskaras and Asanas. Then I have a fruit juice, then do some, have some breakfast, then go to work. And 9 to 10, I always schedule myself. I'm just sharing with all my business experience, not academic student experience. I hope you're comfortable with that.
Yeah, you can.
My achievements goes on day-to-day basis. As I was telling you, as sir was asking me, I plan my day. I never look at.
Mr. Raju,
yeah.
I'm not asking about your day and all. I'm asking regarding your finance. Do you have any achievements like that?
In finance area?
Yes.
Finance area, I didn't. I joined MBA only to achieve that. My objective of joining MBA is that only. I want to know what is finance, what is stock, what is trading, what is analysis, what is balance sheet. And I want to build a career out of it.
Raju, I just want to ask you one question. For example, if you want to give this job to you, and there will be multiple clients who will be working in US, UK, Raju, tell me, how can you convince our clients first?
Thank you.
How can you convince our clients?
Regarding what?
Regarding investments.
Now, I guess if I'm not wrong, your clients are not investors.
Yeah, okay.
Your clients are, you have your clients to process their financial data.
Yeah.
Where you will be charging them.
Where we have our clients all over India.
Okay.
So you want to convince them. For example, if it is an investment processor, consider.
Okay.
How can you convince him?
Honestly, I never thought about converting a client into investor as of now. Maybe in future I'll think about it.
Okay.
As simple as that. After
5 years? 5 years is too long to me. I never look at that long period. I always look at the short term goals.
What is
today?
Your career objective?
My career objective is to excel in finance. Whatever comes on the way. Today I'm an analyst. If you say okay for me, tomorrow I'm something bigger than that. I try to roll on that way. That's how I want.
About that 5 years plan and all.
I was not specific. Ma'am was asking that.
After 5 years, if you want to plan something, why are you not saying that you want
to
do that?
See, being a finance student, I have been closely following BSc and NSC.
Okay.
And I see BSc today 35,000, tomorrow 34,000. And that is a great learning for me. Nothing is stable. If I promise you and say that down the line 5 years, I want to become CEO of your company, I may not become. That is foolish for me. Sorry if I'm taking offending words. For myself. So that way, I believe near-term goals, not just 5 years or 10 years.
Then what is your near-term goal?
That's what I'm saying. I think I already answered the question. I take whatever comes on the way. Today, I'm the financial analyst. So tomorrow, based on my work experience, how you elevate me,
Raju,
it happens.
Raju, you tell me how you balance your stress all the day.
Frankly speaking, there is no stress on me. No one can stress me.
How can we do that?
Try to stress me?
That's good. Raju, please tell me if he is
overconfident.
I'm sorry if I'm looking like that, but I'm like that. That's what I am. I'm sorry for that.
The expression means like you're overconfident.
Okay. But usually in the interview room, out of the interview, I'm like that only. I'm helpless on that. I'm sorry for that.
Do you know about budgeting?
Yeah.
Raju, you said that your father is having a business family background.
True.
And you said that you were trying for a job.
Yeah.
So why the difference, Raju? Why? You want a specific answer, but probably once you earn a decent.
Sorry to stop you, sir. That was his dream.
Yeah.
That is not my dream. As simple as that.
Okay.
So I cannot sail in his boat. I have to sail in my boat. That's how I'm here.
Tell me, Raju, what is your future plans?
You're my future.
If you don't hire you, then what's
I have to check
future?
For another company. We will give me an analyst position. I'm diehard.
Raju, how much you are expecting?
Whatever you give me, I take it. The best.
The best
you offer.
Are you planning to give 8,000 rupees per month?
That is not best for you.
That is best for you.
No. I'm saying
yeah.
You offer whatever you can give me as best for you.
Okay.
I'll take it.
How can you decide that is best for?
Because as I already said that 8,000 is definitely not best for you to offer. You will never. I check your profile.
We decided to 8,000.
I'm sure you will not decide me for 8,000.
From
not even me.
No, how much are you expecting then?
No, I never go with numbers.
Okay.
My passion and pleasure is in work.
So generally people talks about Raju. Is it your first interview? Is it a first job? Are you having any experience?
Sorry, this is my first job.
Okay.
First job interview.
Okay. You tell me, Raju, how much you're expecting?
That's a very tough question to answer for me, I should say that.
Yeah.
Because I'm not here for money. But at the same time, as
you said that you're not working for money. So if you pay 5,000 rupees,
that's what. Let me complete.
Yeah.
I'm not working for money. But at the same time, I should not be underemployed. I should not be undervalued. You pay me whatever you give to others. That's more than okay for me.
Actually, we are planning to reduce our cost.
If it happens to everyone, I will take it. If you are, as sir was saying, if you give 8,000 to me and you are offering the same 8,000 to everyone, I'm happy. But someone is paid, I'm sorry,
yeah,
please go on. If someone is paid with say 30,000, I'm getting 8,000 when we both are NLS, it's really
that
pitching.
Depends on experience. You are a fresher, right?
Assuming we both are freshers, someone is getting 30,000.
No, there is only one vacancy.
Okay. A choice is up to you. You should have the reservations. I'm zero on commenting on that.
Okay, Raju, are you confident that you will get this job?
Very much.
How?
I'm sure I'll get it.
How you are different from others?
I can visualize myself differentiating from others, which you may not visualize or you may not believe, you may not see me. So it is very difficult to convey that to you.
Strength, weakness.
Oh.
Okay.
We'll
let you
know.
At
least tell me
the
greatest strength that you
have. I think I already told you, I'm a go-getter.
I know that. You tell me one greatest strength.
Yeah.
So we based on the strength, we may decide whether you will be recruited or not.
See, I'm a fresh finance graduate
okay.
in masters. And you are looking for the project in finance area.
Yeah.
And I'll fill the gap.
Okay.
There's no other thing bigger than
tell
that.
Me one strength, Raju.
I'm good in financial analysis.
Okay.
Maybe
that is already there in your resume.
Exactly.
We observed that.
Please
that.
Please
and you got the JNT first. Even we saw that. One strongest strength which ignites us to take you off.
I always go with the corporate goals.
Okay.
Whatever it is. Again, going back to my dad's examples. Whether dad was right or wrong, I was following him.
Okay.
So I just follow, that is my strength. I customize myself to others' needs.
Okay.
I think that is my strength.
Raju, will it be always be customized for others' needs? Your strengths?
Because I'm working, I have to.
Okay.
I'm working, it's not a social service. So that way I have to. I'm good in that.
Raju, it was a nice talking to you. We'll give intimation. Have a nice day.
Pleasure talking to you. Thank you, ladies.